Today we're going to be running some Vultr performance benchmarks. So Vultr has been a market leader in terms of its value under $10. So these $6 servers have been a real mainstay for the things I've been working on. These high frequency servers have been available for a few years now. 3.7 gigahertz Xeon servers for this price has been pretty much unbeatable. So they did recently launch these two new ones. So a few weeks ago, I was launching some servers and I noticed these two new options, but wasn't really sure which one to pick. I stuck with my high frequency as usual, but I really want to test these two out and see how they go. I'm going to run them through several different benchmarks and see what I can recommend to you guys. So if all this sounds interesting, then keep watching. So there's a few benchmarks that I ran to make this video. Geekbench 5, very CPU intensive to check the CPU performance. We've also got a more broad server performance test with Sysbench, so we can check the memory, the file IO, and the MySQL database performance. Next up, I know there's a lot of WordPress users who watch these videos, so I've got WP Performance Tester and WordPress Hosting Benchmark Tool. Now, this one's quite good because Kevin Ohashi does a lot of benchmarking across the whole industry, and this test will actually give you a comparison of your server versus the industry average, which is quite good to know as well. So I'm just going to get straight into the results so you can see how these stack up. All right, starting off with Geekbench 5 with our Geekbench score. So AMD High Performance actually won this test. This is the new High Performance server, probably about 10% up from the previous favorite here, Vultr High Frequency. So the nice thing about this one is you get a little bit of information about the actual server here. So you can see that we've got the old Intel High Frequency is an Intel Skylake running at 3.7. This AMD High Performance is your AMD Epic Rome series. So this is only a couple of years old, running at 2 gigahertz. This one's probably 5 or 6 years old now, but it runs at 3.7 gigahertz, which really has been a big advantage for a long time. And we've got the Intel High Performance, which is Cascade Lake, a newer iteration of the Xeon series. Now, this one's the older one, Skylake, and then Cascade Lake is a couple of years old. So running at a slower clock though, so 2.9 gigahertz here compared to 3.7. So this one actually is still faster in terms of its Geekbench score. Next up, we got memory performance from Sysbench benchmarking. Now these are all pretty close together, within 5% of each other. So not much difference here. Interesting that the older Intel High Frequency is actually the quickest still. So again, I wouldn't really expect this to make any noticeable difference in practice. So I think we could pretty much call this one a tie. All right, next up, we've got Sysbench MySQL database performance. Again, the old Intel High Frequency is outperforming the newer options here. So that's a little bit disappointing. I would have thought the new stuff would be better, but again, I don't think this is all about CPU. The database performance is particularly related to the drives, the memory, the overall quality of the build here. And it just might be the case that these 3.7 gigahertz setups are just a higher end server, and these ones are just more cheaper mid-range type stuff. A bit disappointed that AMD, despite having good CPU performance, is struggling compared to its competitors with the database performance. This test is obviously really important for a lot of web applications like online stores where you've got multiple users creating, adding, removing data from the database simultaneously. This is going to affect the user experience. So I think Intel High Frequency is the recommended choice for those kind of applications. Next up, the file IO performance. Now, this probably explains part of that database performance issue. So in AMD here is struggling and compared with the Intel's for its file IO. I don't know if this is a hardware related. Maybe the drives on the Intel are better than what you get on the AMD. I'm not sure if it's software or something is causing this one to bottleneck the results that AMD is putting out compared to Intel here. So the Intel High Performance, actually, this is the first one that they won in terms of the benchmarks. Intel High Frequency coming second there and lagging behind there is that AMD. On to our WordPress performance. So this is the Kevin Ohashi's test here. So industry average, 2.4 seconds for the WordPress performance test. Now, all of these beat the industry average. So all of these are good options for running WordPress, but notably Intel High Frequency, the old processor actually wins this benchmark. So 0.9 seconds to complete the WordPress test, the overall server test, 9.6 seconds, industry average is 10.6. So all of these, incredibly, at only $6 outperform the industry average. So that's really cool, particularly for running WordPress. I really like recommending these Intel High Frequency VPS to people who are running WordPress. So yeah, I'm not surprised. I am a little bit disappointed that AMD hasn't been able to keep up, or particularly that it's offered at the same price point. If this was cheaper, it probably should be cheaper given that it's not it's not touching the result of the Intel high frequency here. So again, disappointing from AMD. I can still recommend Intel high frequency. And finally, WordPress hosting benchmark tool, the same result here, Intel high frequency wins again, overall score of 7.7, AMD lagging behind a little bit here, but yeah, I mean, decent results across the board, but we can see the database performance there. That is probably the bottleneck. I'm not sure what is causing that. If that is software related, hopefully that can be fixed, but if it's bottlenecked in the hardware or the drive somehow, then that's disappointing, but Intel high frequency is probably still my choice. All right, conclusions. Hello to anyone who has skipped forward to this part of the video. I'm Alex from IdeaSpot. I still recommend Intel high frequency for most web applications, particularly WordPress. It was comfortably winning those benchmarks. So a little bit disappointing that AMD, despite having better CPU performance in Geekbench, it wasn't able to keep up when you look at the actual file input output and the database performance where Intel high frequency was still better. So there may still be some CPU intensive tasks where AMD is better, something like encoding, transcoding, cryptography, some science or engineering specific tasks may benefit from having a better CPU, but the overall drive and system performance is gonna be better with Intel high frequency. So that is still my pick. If I was running a server, I'd go with this by default. So yeah, if you wanna try these out, 14 days of free credit, a link in the description. I really like these, I recommend these to pretty much anyone who wants to set up their own server, I'd go with this. So let me know what you think in the comments, but thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.